9절 20절 두 절을 우리 합독을
Verses 19 through 20 we'll all read in one voice. Then they cried to the Lord in their trouble, and He delivered them from their distress. He sent out His word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. Amen. Let us bless each other. Be at peace. You're the missionaries to save the world. Let us receive the inheritance of the desolate heritages.
Hallelujah.
Inside of the world that is like the ocean, the reason why we are able to not waver and shake, it is because God has given us the word. There are many things that arise inside of the world, but the mystery to have victory over that, it is because we have the lamp, the word that is given to us. Even today, before we go out to the world, may we stand before the word. I bless you in the name of the Lord. May you restore that strength. For us, we have something that moves us. There's something that is inside of us that moves us. And what is that? Is it the environment? Or is it the many conditions or situations? Yes, that can also move us. But what is inside of us truly moves us. Then if our lives are not restored and organized inside of the word, then we cannot live the way we want. If the word is not organized inside of us, and if our lives not organized inside of the world, then we will be dragged along by the world. But if our lives are organized inside of the Word of God, then we receive the guidance of the Holy Spirit. And no matter what situations may come our way, we are able to enjoy true peace. That is why when you take a look at the figures inside of the Bible, they did not live their lives. They received the guidance of the Holy Spirit of God and lived their life following after that the Holy Spirit that was with them. And that is why it was okay even though they were chased and enslaved. It didn't matter if they met a problem like a storm. And it didn't matter even if they went inside of the prison. Rather, you're able to see that they had victory in all of the conditions, environments, and problems. Then we too have received that same salvation. And we too are receiving the guidance of the same Holy Spirit. But why are we always falling down and crumbling before the problems that's not even a percent or 0.1% harder than the past? Why are we always angry and falling into discouragement, anxiety, and complaints? We also make other people fall into trial. What is that reason? the early church and the figures that are inside of the Bible, they overcame even death. But for us, we are faced with a small problem and we are falling into trial, and we also make other people fall into trial. We receive the same salvation and the same Holy Spirit dwells inside of us. But why is that the case? It is because our lives are not organized inside of the Word of God. Then we must organize our lives inside of the Word of God, and we must heal the incorrect imprints that are inside of us. Here in today's passage, you can see that David prayed in distress. And if you see in verse 20 today, he says, he sent out his word. So they cried to the Lord in their troubles. And here you can see that he said, he sent out his word.
하나님 말씀이 임하는 것이고 그 말씀이 내 삶 속에
What does it mean by that he has sent out his word? It is the word coming upon us and giving us the evidence according to the word. And you're able to see that in the Bible it says the word of the Lord came upon so and so. And Jeremiah prayed to God. He was faced with the crisis. And he was caught in the courtyard of the guard.
But it says,
for the second time, the word of the Lord came upon
Jeremiah.
If the word is organized inside of our lives, then we are able to see that the word leads us.
인도받기 위해서 말씀이 우리의 삶에
Then in order for the word to lead us and for us to organize our lives inside of the word, there's something that we must heal, the wrong imprints that are inside of us. We first must know that our lives are inside of the word. When we walked our walk of faith in the past, how was it? We will hold on to the title, and we pray, holding on to the prayer topics that are given to us. And the same for the elders that pray on the Lord's Day. And the same for the deacons that pray. And we have the deaconesses that also pray as well. When they pray, I'm able to see that they're holding on to the pulpit message and living their lives. But how was it like in the past? We will listen to the word, and even before we leave the church, we will forget the word. And we live our lives struggling inside of the world, and we come back on the Lord's Day. If there is a funny example that is given inside of the word, then we do not forget that, but we forget the word. And we listen to a funny story, or a touching story, then we remember that more than the word. And you're able to see that we live our lives that has no relation with the word. That is why we cannot walk the walk of faith. The word and our walk of faith are totally different, and the word and our fields are totally different. And that is why we have no choice but to shake and crumble. The word was matched must match with me.
나와 맞는 것을 가지고 그걸 가지고 신앙생활을 한다라고 하는 것입니다.
The word matching with me, we call that the walk of faith.
이 말씀이 현장과 맞게 되어 있습니다.
This word absolutely matches with the field.
중요한 부분들이죠.
And that is why we must hold on to the word, and that is the most important key for evangelism.
흐름들을 알고 있어야 되는 것입니다.
And that is why we must know the very important stream inside of the Bible. What is the important stream inside of the Bible?
주님께서 우리 인생에게 해결을 주기 위한 언약을 주셨습니다.
God has given us the covenant so that He can solve all of our life problems.
창세기 3장 15절입니다.
And that is Genesis 3:15.
여자의 후손이 너의 머리를 상하게 할 것이다 했어.
The offspring of the woman will crush and it shall bruise your head.
그리고 하나님을 떠나버린 것이죠.
The mankind that were created in the image of God, they were deceived by Satan, and they committed sin, and they were separated from God, and now they're in the law of sin and death.
그런 인생이 아닙니다.
It's not the life that we truly want.
내가 원하는 대로 살아갈 수 없는 매인 몸이 되어진 것입니다.
We have become bound where we cannot live our life.
이야기하는 것이 있잖아요.
And that is why many people easily say this. Your life is not done. You cannot live your life the way you want.
그렇습니다. 내 인생 내 마음대로 안 되는 겁니다.
Yes, that's right. We cannot live the life the way we want. We are always bound by something.
그 배경은 영원한 지옥 배경이고요.
And that background is eternal hell.
매여서 살아가는 존재가 되어 버린.
And we have become a being where we are dragged by Satan.
죄인이다라고 합니다.
And we call them the sinners.
그것을 보고 타락한 인생이다 이야기를 하고 있습니다.
And we call that the corrupted life.
그런 우리를 살리기 위해서 언약을 주셨습니다.
But to us who are bound by that, God has given us the covenant. Is Genesis 3:15, the offspring of woman will crush the head of the serpent.
사단의 머리를 깨뜨리심으로 우리가 구원 얻는 길을 여신다라는 사실입니다.
It means that He will open up the way for salvation and crush the head of Satan.
그래서 성경은 창세기 3장 15절을 설명하고 증거하고 보여주는 것이 바로 성경의 기록인 것입니다.
And the Bible is recorded to show us the evidence of the Genesis 3:15.
그 문제를 해결하는 답인 창세기 3장 15절의 기록이 없다면은
if there's no record of Genesis 3 and Genesis 3:15,
잘못 이해하게 되는 것입니다.
Even though we read the other passages of the Bible, we understand incorrectly.
전부 창세기 3장 15절을 성취하고 입증하고 설명하는 것이 바로 성경인 것입니다.
The Bible is recorded to show us the evidence and the fulfillment of Genesis 3:15. That is why we call Genesis 3:15 the original gospel, the first gospel.
창세기 3장 15절을 통해서 모든 인생의 해답과 응답을 주시는 것입니다.
So through the Genesis 3:15 has given us all of the solutions and the answers.
다른 게 아니에요.
There is no other thing.
하나님의 흐름 속에서 창세기 3장과 그것을 해결하는 창세기 3장 15절 원시 복음에 대해서 반드시 알고 있어야 합니다.
If you want to know the stream of the Bible, then you must absolutely know the original gospel, the Genesis 3:15. If you don't know this, then you don't know the Bible.
한 시대가 지나가기 전에 이미 이 사실을 놓쳐버림으로 말미암아 문제가 왔잖아요.
You can see all the people are faced with the problem because they have lost hold of this. And that first incident was Cain and Abel. Cain had lost hold of the covenant that was given to us.
다른 말로 하면은 종교를 따라가게 되었다는 거.
That is why Cain followed after religion.
그래서 결국은 최초의 살인자가 되어버린 겁니다.
And he became the first murderer of this world.
그게 이 여자의 후손의 언약을 붙잡은 한 사람이 있었습니다.
But there was one person that held on to the covenant of the offspring of woman, and that was Abel. And he gave the sacrificial offering inside of the covenant. And even till this day, we call him the person of faith. Abel was stoned and died from Cain, but his faith is relayed to us.
사람들이 언약을 잃어버리고 우상 숭배에 빠진 것입니다.
And if you see in Genesis 6, many people have lost hold of the covenant of the offspring of woman.
나팔이라고 위에서 하늘에서 떨어진 자의 의미를 갖고 있는 뜻입니다.
It came the age of the Nephilim. The Nephilim, the original meaning, Nepal, means a person that has fallen from above. And who has fallen above is Satan. And that is why idolatry culture and the culture of corruption continues. And during the age of the Nephilim, God chose Noah to save that age, and you can see the Noah's flood. In Genesis 11, if you see here, people built the Tower of Babel. And it was a culture where they were going up against God. Even before one century went by, this kind of problem arose. And that's why they became enslaved for 400 years to Egypt. It is because the covenant of Genesis 3:15 was cut off. That is why they were held captives or were enslaved by Egypt. And that is why God gives the covenant again. He says, I will lead you out of Egypt. And after 400 years, you're able to see the Israelites were set free from Egypt. You're able to see the stream continuously flowing towards restoration. And through church history and through the Bible, it tells us what the original gospel is and the covenant that is given to us. And if you see in the religious reformation, you're able to see through Luther, God restored the covenant again and the gospel again. And through that, we are able to receive the word today.
여러분 말씀을 받을 때마다 이 복음의 정확한 흐름이 지금 내게 전달되었다는 이 사실들이 꽉 박혀져야 합니다.
So you must be able to see that the stream of the word has flown all the way down to me, and this word is being given to me. For our fundamentals and for our health to be restored, it is when we restore the covenant.
고통 중에서 하나님께 부르짖었다 했어요. 거기에 대한 응답으로
Again,
그가 그의
passage,
말씀을 우리에게 보냈다 말씀하고
cry to the Lord in their troubles.
말씀이 임하게 될 때 우리의 인생과 우리의 근본이
But God, He sent out the word and healed them.
그리고 그렇게 임한 하나님의 말씀은 반드시 성취되게 돼 있어요.
And the word that is spoken from God is absolutely fulfilled.
내가 나를 위해서 하는 것이 아니라 정말로 하나님이 나를 위해서 무엇을 하시려고 하는가 그것을 관심 있게 되고 그것을 찾게 돼 있습니다.
Because the word of God is fulfilled, we are able to have interest in not how what I want to live, but what God wants to do with my life.
우리가 사는 길은 말씀으로 사는 것입니다.
We live by the word. We hold on to the word and we pray. And we see the witnesses, or the evidence that are given to us, and we live to relay that evidence. And when you hold on to the word, you're able to see the person that truly needs this word.
사도행전 3장에 보면은 베드로와 요한이 나면서 못 걷게 된 자를 만났습니다.
If you see in Acts 3, you're able to see a Peter, he meets a crippled man from birth.
안전뱅이로 있으면서 성전 미문에서 구걸 하던 사람이었습니다.
He was a crippled man that was begging in front of the gate called the Beautiful.
왔다 갔다 하는 그 자리에서 그날 주목해서 봤다 했어.
And as Peter was going back and forth, he
그리고 그
looked to the crippled man. 이야기했습니다. And he spoke to the crippled man.
사도행전 3장 6절에 보면 은과 금은 내게 없다.
Acts
3:6
it says I have no silver and gold, but what I have I give to you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Rise up and walk. This crippled man, all of the Jews knew about him. The Jewish people, they have this habit of going to the temple during every feast. And that is why all of the Jewish people knew the crippled man. But Peter looked carefully at this crippled man. And to that crippled man, he proclaims, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And you're able to see all of the Jewish people listening to the word of God. That is our walk of faith. That is the blessing that we must enjoy. The word comes upon us, and when we see the fulfillment of the word, we are able to find and discover the things that God has prepared for me. If we keep on discovering that, we are able to see the field. And enjoying that, we call that the walk of faith. We must enjoy this blessing. Because we do not enjoy this blessing and we cannot taste this, we keep on looking towards the worldly things that will disappear later on. Take a look at our prayers. You're able to see that we ask for things that the people of the world ask as well. I bless you in the name of the Lord. May the Lord, word come upon you and may the word lead you. Second, that we must apply the word of God inside of our lives. And we call that imprinting. We have received training till now. The book of Genesis and book of Exodus, we have received training.
주중에 진행되는 우리 평신도 제자 훈련은 그리스도 중심에서 성경을 보고 그리스도 중심에서 모든 것들을 볼 수 있도록 그렇게 준비한 시스템입니다.
We have this training. It's a system where we look at the Bible centered around Christ.
그렇다면 지금부터 그 말씀이 내게 삶 속에 정착되어야 됩니다.
Then that word must be applied inside of our lives.
정리되어져야 된다는 말입니다.
It means that our lives must be organized with the word.
이미 우리에게 각인된 모든 것들이 말씀으로 정리되어지면 치유되어져야 된다는 말입니다.
All of the things that are imprinted inside of us, that must be all healed by organization of the word. So this incorrect things are imprinted, rooted down, and has become a nature to us.
그러니까 결국은 내 영혼이 병들어 버린 것이죠.
And that is why our soul and also our body has
말은 무슨 말입니까?
Has been diseased.
기도하고 말씀 가지고 살아가야 되잖아요.
We must truly hold on to the word and pray, and we must live our life in faith.
불신앙하고 염려하고 두려움하고 인본주의 쓰는 것 그게 영혼이 병든 겁니다.
But we are giving unbelief and falling into anxiety, fear, and using humanistic ways. That is what it means by our soul has been diseased. Then we must receive the answer of healing the disease, healing the diseased soul. The Israelites stood in front of the flood, or the Red Sea.
딱 한 사람 모세만 하나님의 역사를 고백한 것을 보게 됩니다.
And only one person, Moses, spoke about the works of God. You guys stand still and see the work that the Lord will do, and you will see the Egyptians that you have seen till now no more. And you're able to see Moses gives that confession of faith. All of the Israelites that followed after Moses and came out of Egypt, they were complaining and grumbling. And what were they complaining about? They were saying, oh, why did you lead us out of Egypt and make us die in this wilderness? And those are the complaints and the resentments of the Israelites. What was imprinted inside of the hearts of the Israelites came out. The diseased souls and what is incorrectly imprinted inside of us can be only healed through the Word of God. And that is why day by day we must be able to see the Word of God. It is same for us. Assistant Pastor Jin-Yong Kim said this. He said this during the early morning prayer service. Someone called the summit school.
지금 2학년인데 학교 중단하고 스미스 스쿨에 보내고 싶다라고 전화를 주셨대.
This one person called him and said, "Can I send my child to that school?"
누군가 물으니까 교회 다니는 분이 아니에요.
And this person was not a church member.
근데 어떻게 이분이 그렇게 전화를 주셨느냐?
How did this person call that school?
자기 동네에서 자기 가까이 있는 아이를 하나 보니까 너무나 반듯하고 좋아요.
This one person saw a student from
알고 보니까 우리 하나 스미스쿨에 다니는 아이.
Inside of their neighborhood, and he was so well. And it was a student from our Hana Summit School, and that is why this person called the pastor saying, I want to send my child to the Hana Summit School. There is a time when the teachers from outside come and say, or teach our students. And what is the reason? Because when they view our students, they're so different. And they're so kind, and they're different from others. Yes, people can become genuine and kind. And living an upright life, yes, that's also correct, but the Bible does not speak of that. The Word is power and Word is life. The Word is the Spirit to save. The Bible doesn't teach us saying live a kind life. And some people with knowledge, they see this, the Bible, as some kind of history. But they truly do not know the Word. The Word, it is the Spirit to save, and it is the power to save. That is why if you see in John 6:63, it is the Spirit who gives life, the flesh is no help. And all the words that I have spoken to you are Spirit and life. It says, the words that I have spoken, it is the Spirit and life. It is telling us the Word of God, it is the Spirit and life.
우리가 말씀을 들을 때마다 그 말씀이 우리를 살아나게 하는 것입니다.
And that is why when we listen to the Word of God, our souls come to life. Through the Word, we receive power. Through the Word, we receive healing. And through the Word, the forces of darkness breaks down. And that is why we must imprint the Word inside of us. How do we imprint? And that is why we must have the time of holy meditation. We must raise up this holy meditation movement. Right now, many of the elites of the world, they've fallen into transcendental meditation. You must see why they have fallen into that.
묵상운동, 너무나 좋은 묵상운동을 놓쳐버렸기 때문에 세상은 명상운동을 통해서 많은 애를
들었어요. It is because we have lost hold of this great, precious holy meditation movement. That is why the world stole this and called it a transcendental meditation. So we must change all of the wrong imprints inside of us. And if you see in Psalms 1:1-6, it tells us who are blessed and who are not. Who are people who are blessed?
오직 여호와의 율법을 즐거워하여 그의 율법을 주야로 묵상하는 자로다.
But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and on his law he meditates day and night.
그런 것으로 끝나면 조금 지나면 다 잃어버리게 돼, 잊어버리게 돼.
If you don't meditate upon the word, then we lose hold of the word.
자꾸 묵상하면은 그것이 우리의 뇌의 영혼의 영혼으로 연결되게 돼 있어.
But when we hold on to the word and we meditate upon it day and night, then this will be imprinted inside of our brains, our spirit, and our soul.
말씀이 생각나지고 기도가 되어지면은 말씀이 우리의 생각과 우리의 모든 것을 치유하기 시작하는.
Then you are able to remember the word, and when you remember the word and hold onto that and pray, you are able to receive strength. And that is why if you see the figures inside of the Bible, they always held onto the word and prayed.
말씀을 가지고 깊은 기도 속에서 묵상함으로 여러분의 영혼이 치유되어지는 귀한 축복 있기를 주여 여러분 축원합니다.
I bless you in the name of the Lord. May you hold on to the word and go into deep concentration, and may all of your souls receive healing. If you see in Psalms 5:3, in the morning, and if you see in 17:3 during the night, and in Psalms 119:147-148, it tells us something very important. It is showing the relationship with David and God. In 147, it tells us, I rise before dawn and cry for help. I hope in your words. And in 148, my eyes are awake before the watches of the night, that I may meditate on your promise.
시편 119편 10절 11절에 보면은 다윗은 자기가 범죄치 아니하려 주의 말씀을.
If you see in Psalms 119:10, it tells us with my whole heart.
시편 119편 130절 131절 한번 보십시다.
And let us read this verse, Psalms 130-131. The unfolding of your words gives light. It imparts understanding to the simple. I open my mouth and pant because I long for your commandments.
빛이 비추어서 우둔한 사람을 깨닫게 한다고 했습니다.
The word gives light, and it imparts understanding to the simple. And if you see in Revelations 19:13, it is a very important passage. Let us all read together. He is clothed in the robe dipped in blood, and the name by which he is called is the Word of God. Jesus Christ, it is the Word of God. That is why healing have no choice but to take place. Really, I truly hope that you have the holy meditation movement take place where you hold on to the word and go into deep concentration. If you do not receive healing inside of the holy meditation movement, holding on to the word, then we have no strength. And that is why we are always confused inside of our lives. Then how can we imprint the word inside of us? We can cite the word, and we can also write the word. And that is all the time where we imprint the word. I always come to church at 9 o'clock in the morning. Then before going into my room, I go through the hallway. And there are people who are early in the morning come and are writing something down. So they're writing down and citing the prayers. How far must we do this? We do it until the Word of God becomes my praise. And when that takes place, then our lives become different. So citing the Word is very important as well. And there are believers who receive the word during the early morning prayer service, and they cite the word as they exercise. And that is power. Even Jesus, when he was chasing out Satan, he utilized the word in Deuteronomy, in the book of Deuteronomy. Luther, he held on to the word and started the religious reformation. And that was the book of Romans 1:16. For I am not ashamed of the gospel. It was the age where all of the people who were ashamed and embarrassed of the gospel, Luther said he is not ashamed of the gospel. That's the word that he held on to. And the righteous shall live by faith. And Luther made the Catholics kneel down. Luther, he was holding on to the word of God that was given to him. And there was a confession of faith of Habakkuk. All the people must live by faith, and holding on to that, Luther started the religious reformation. So we could cite the word, and we can write down the words, and this word must become my strength. And we are able to truly have victory inside of our lives. I'll come to the end of my words. What God has given us, it is the Word of God. And with that word, our lives and our daily lives must be organized. I told you this in the early morning prayer service. When we say we have received answers to our prayers, people of the world view that answer as, did I make a lot of money or not? But answer, the true answer, it is the situation.
영적 세계가 먼저 만들어지는 것.
Through prayer,
가장 먼저 영적
the 세계가 spiritual world, spiritual realm being made inside of us, that is the true answer.
그리고 현실 세계로 나타나게 돼.
And now that is revealed to our lives.
영적 세계가 내 안에 만들어져.
So what is the most important answer that is
언제입니까?
Must be answered to us? It is the word of God being made inside of us.
결국 그것이 나를 이끌어 가게 돼.
And that spiritual world will lead us.
환경과 조건과 상황이 나를 만들어 가는 것이 아닙니다.
The environments and conditions are not the things that make us.
여러분을 이끌어 가는 그런 삶으로 들어가는 축복 있기를 주의 이름으로
축복. I really bless you in the name of the Lord. May the word truly lead you.
시편 107편 19절 20절 이번 한 주간의 말씀을 묵상하세요.
Really meditate upon the word that was given today.
특별히 20절 한번 읽어보십시오.
Let us all read together again the verse 20.
같이 읽겠습니다. 그가
He sent out His word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction.
할렐루야.
할렐루야.
그가 그의 말씀을 보내어
He sent out His word and healed them and delivered them from their destructions.
말씀인 그리스도를 보내시사
God has sent us the word who is Jesus Christ and will deliver us from destruction. I bless you in the name of the Lord. May you have true victory.
함께 말씀 붙잡고 기도하는 시간 갖기를 원합니다.
Let us have the time.
찬양은 주의 말씀을 나 간절히 주의 말씀이라는 찬양이고요. 기도 제목들 한번 확인하십시다. 하나님의 말씀의 흐름 속에 있는 전도 제자의 기도입니다. 같이 한번 읽어보십시다. 하나님의 말씀을 중심해서 나의 인생 삶이 정리되게 하옵소서. 말씀의 흐름 속에 있는 정인의 삶이 누려지게 하옵소서. 우리의 영적 싸움의 힘 무기가 되어 승리케 하시는 하나님의 말씀이 각인되게 하옵소서. 이 기도 제목들 여러분 마음에 담으면서 함께 찬양하겠습니다. 주의